Hey, how are you guys doing today? I hope you're all absolutely doing amazing. So here's what we're doing. So the Jester D-1, standing behind there. I felt that I looked like an NPC right there. So the Jester D-1, as a blueprint, if you're doing weapon engineering and stuff like that, it pops a ridiculous amount of blueprints. It's like, I believe the one you get from the technician itself. I'm gonna double check that before I actually say that. Hold on one second. Yeah, Jester D1. So it's one of the ones you get from the technician. So everybody has access to this. So today, I'm gonna do a 1000 clicky click run on the D1. The blueprint we're gonna start out with is at 35. No, that's not that. That's my level. Is it 60? I was like, I know, I've worked it more than that. Is it 65.1 starting out? So we'll get that circled. I'm going to do a 1000 click run. If you Google this and actually check the Entropia wiki site, the Jester D1 absolutely has a ridiculous list of blueprints it can pop. So we're going to generate a good amount of blueprints. For my engineering stuff, my engineering is really high. Blueprint comp is off the charts-ish balance-wise, you know what I mean? And everything else is within reason. The only thing we're going to be missing on this run is industrialist, which we don't get access to till level 60 as an item crafter of some kind. And it has, you know, that's a little bit of ways. So I'm going to go ahead and get this started. Like with all the crafting runs I do, I'm going to have this set like this. We're going to be able to see what kind of blueprints pop. I want to make sure I don't have any blueprints in here first. This is going to show you the exact ped amount of what's going on, down to a greater decimal point than what happens over here or even on here. So it is absolutely more accurate. Here you're going to be able to see some of the skill progression going on. I always pop my face out of here, so I'm not just sitting here for over an hour watching it. I will be watching it. I just don't think you guys need to see me visually watching it. I will discuss any blueprint that happens or any major event, and I will go back over it at the end when we're done with the entire run, and we'll look at what all we got. And so, cross your fingers, send positive vibes. I hope good things at your day, and let's get this thing going. Okay, and so the skills are starting to run in. So we're not necessarily concerned with the guns. They have some kind of markup on them. I don't think you should ever focus on that with these runs. Honestly, I'll probably check them at the end, and if one of them has like a perfect upgrade stat, I might would keep it. But on large runs like this, a lot of times, I really am legitimately going to trade terminal the stuff out because we are after the blueprints and the skills, not the actual gun itself. I didn't want to forget the 50% more skill part. Okay, so we just globaled, and we got a bunch of these, which, by the way, these are valuable. 5,000% markup. And so, boom, pimping. We're doing good right now. So that's one global so far. I'm not sure we'll get more globals, but we'll get more blueprints. But that's a good sign so far, right? Yeah, I think so. Okay, so that's a pretty good pack of those. Not great. We're doing pretty good on ped-wise, though, here. Let's look at the markup. 500% markup. I believe I have plenty of these already. Laser pistol, 35. These have great markup on them, though. And I don't really make these. I usually sell them. But it's a pretty good thing if you are a tool crafter. Those are good. Okay, so we're approaching the 1/4 mark right here. And so let's hope that we do as well in the next 750 clicky clicks as we've done in this first part. Okay, so this weapon tech gizmo thing, I've been actually TTing them. And I know that, I don't know if that's like the right thing. I just don't feel that they sell at a high enough velocity to justify using one of my 50 auction slots. And sometimes they auction fail. And so if somebody needed one of these, I would hook them up because this is a very important blueprint, also, by the way. This generates a lot of weapon blueprints. And so, it just, a lot of people generate them also. And so, it's not what I consider a valuable blueprint. Okay, so these short blades. They have a reasonable markup. I think a lot of people make those. I like making them. They're pretty easy to make. They basically are all the basic component stuff. And so. And they sell at a reasonable velocity. I think that they usually have a markup of 110%, I mean 120% for those. But I'd have to check because I wouldn't want to misquote that. Not the blueprint. The blueprint, good markup. But just just crafting was also effective. How many did we get? 59? Yeah, that's a good amount. Okay, so that's a considerable amount of Dominax. I think I have some of these maybe in the thing, but 800% markup. I'll have to actually look. We might have some of those already. Not sure. Okay, so this is 82 stack of LR25s. LR25 sell? That's not that high of a markup, honestly, on that. I would probably rather make the gun, just to be honest. And so I'll probably keep some of these weapon stacks. These whip stacks I'm more likely to sell. I've never really made a lot of whips. Never really been into that market. The markup usually on whip stacks is pretty good. It's not amazing, but that's okay. You can only make so much stuff, right? I don't know what just happened. We'll check. 34th level plasma engineer. You know, the sad part is I don't have a bunch of... That's not a bad hit, C-13 pad. I don't have any plasma engineering items that are reasonable to make. Like, every plasma weapon I can craft pretty much would require me to use Dunkel, in which that makes it impractical to craft. And so, it is what it is. I would like to pop a plasma weapon that was reasonable for production for everybody, but to date, this has not occurred. Okay, we got 24 ped, plus we got a good blueprint. These 40s actually sell for a bunch. There's just like not as big a market. But this is much more in the zone of what I would prefer to make. Because these sell better on like Crystal Palace and stuff like that. Things of this nature. trying to make sure to write down everything that I pop off of everything on each planet. Okay, so we've got some BC-30s too. And that's a 25 hit right here. Look at that. That's not bad at all. So we're doing good. I don't know exactly how well, but pretty good, I would say. And we're at the 2 or 3/4 mark right now. Okay, so here's a weapon, Techno Gizmo 3. I could probably put that in, but I actually will probably TT it if somebody doesn't directly need it. So if somebody actually needs these and they want to say something, that's cool. Outside of that, that's a going trading terminal. But these are just used to pop more blueprints, in all honesty. And so, we got more 30s. Thank you. Okay, so we're pretty far into this now. Honestly, this went well. And so, I don't know. I mean, like, I'm not going to say we're positive, but we got a global during it. It just was like a 50 pet global, but we got multiple really nice hits. And we'll be able to see them all because it's a 1,000 pet run. I mean, 1,000 click, not 1,000 pet. I apologize. 1,000 clicks is as far back as you can look in the history of the value stuff, which is really annoying. They definitely should fix it. You should be able to see the back pool on a maybe 10,000 run clicky click style or something. I don't know. Who knows the sweet middle ground? So while this was going though, check this out. Bang! I finished a wall hanging. I know, right? Probably not as excited as I am on it. But it's a giant smiley face. So that's another 14 ped. And we got some BP20 blueprints. I'm going to be honest. See, here's the thing with these. Wait, let me make sure I read that right. Yeah. For some reason, when I went to write it, I was writing PB20. Okay. So, realistically, when you're doing weapon crafting, unless you want to have a crap inventory of stuff, as you can see, you need a lot of stuff with each of these weapons. And so, and it's kind of in the zone. Like, all of the 30s are going to need basically the same kind of stuff, you know. But if you wanted to keep making, like, all of these different groupings, you would just end up with so much material. It would be ridiculous. It's much easier to pick, like, a category that you're really good at. Well, my opinion. That's not a, hey, this is the rule. But I feel it's much easier to specialize-ish. And it's much cheaper inventory upkeep. Because you're really looking at just a crap ton of inventory. And the value on some of these is good. I mean, like, let's pick some of the ones I don't make. So, I don't make BP20s. I don't know the value of this. Let's look. 400% markup. That's not great. I don't really make these either, though. So, I'm not sure why that's worth the 1,000% sum. Laser rifles. I make the crap out of laser rifles. We like that. Short blades sell like crazy, too. People that make short blades do well. Yeah, I figured that would be worth a bunch. Ooh, that kind of made me have a little, what the crap, I thought I was being attacked. I mean, it's not even PvP zone or anything, but loud, random. Definitely probably drank too much coffee today. That's a sign of that. So, I do hope you guys are having an epic day. I mean, like, it looks like we're slaughtering here. That's a pretty good amount of ped right there in just residue and metal crap. Just to be honest, you guys. Like, this looks good. I couldn't tell you if we've pulled ahead, though. Like, that's a mystery at this point. So, pretty good amount of restocking on stuff to craft, though, right? Does anybody actually need these by any chance? Because I'm TTing these weapon gizmos if somebody doesn't actually need them. And that's just because I don't really like putting things that don't sell into the auction house. But when somebody needs some, because these are base blueprints, right? This is going to pop a crap load of stuff. This is going to pop a bunch of stuff around tier 3. And so they're pretty simplistic on the way these work. They're straightforward. So are, honestly, all the gestures. The gestures, I haven't ran the gesture 3 yet. I have the blueprint for it. But the 2's pretty straightforward. And so is the one, honestly. They just pump out a bunch of stuff within their area. Okay. And those gizmos are the exact same way. It's just the gizmos are very dialed in, it seems like. And I will be doing a weapon gizmo run. I'm gonna do all these runs on Cyrene also. We're heading back to Cyrene to work on the manufacture weapons skill with the Cyrene daily soon. I just literally had to re-up all of our ped and stuff like that. I have to re get back up. So we're gonna have to actually be on this planet crafting and doing some stuff for like a week or so, which isn't a big deal, but it will allow us to prepare to head to Cyrene, and we can get some runs that can we can kind of look at as a comparison. Man, it won't be an accurate comparison. We'd have to do way more than one run. But if we're looking for an anecdotal comparison, I will provide you it. I don't know if that's up to tell you guys, but it's where we're at. I do think this went well. I hope you guys are doing kick butt and all your guys' adventure today. I know this is kind of strange adventuring, but I really like the generating blueprint aspect of the game. I'm gonna just be honest with you guys. I find it fascinating. Plus, it allows me to keep in stock with the things that I make. And the stuff I don't make, I can always vend off to somebody else that does make it. Or aspires to make it. Which you never know. I bought so many blueprints aspirationally when I first started this game. And once in a great while, I'll still do it. Like, where it's not even one I'm gonna make for a long time. But who knows if it will be easy to get? Because that stuff changes. Pretty sure I've grabbed up on my blueprint greed a couple blueprints that if I wouldn't have, I would not be getting them now at all. There's no way I would find them. Okay, boom. Let's look at what happened. We got a global. We got a 25, a 24, a 15, a 14, and so on. And so overall, we did well. Statistics on it is that we got 855.16 ped in value. That's believable. And so I would buy that. I did not put that much in, by the way. And so we did actually come out ahead on this run, but not by a ton. So for blueprints, we've got these garters. They have awesome markup. I'll sell those. I don't make those. Those don't have great markup. I do make this kind of stuff, though, laser pistols and stuff. So that doesn't have great markup, but those are something I would make and load into the auction house. These, nobody said they needed, so they're going to go into the trade terminal. These, I might pump out some of them, or I might sell this. I'm not really sure. That's a mixed bag. We already went over that. I make those. I would make those. These, I would sell. Honestly, I don't do these. And so I'll put that into auction. This goes to trade terminal. So, as you could see, the amount of stuff you would have to keep up a diversity of these kind of things is ridiculous. And so, kind of a fun run, at least, right? I mean, it was a profitable run, so that's always nice. And so, I hope that helps you guys. They're not always profitable, by the way. Even with my skill level, I should expect to be down 5% per run. And so that's just reality. And so without markup applied to things, or without the ability to make a future item that's profitable off of it, it would not be profitable. You know what I'm saying? So I hope this helps you guys out. I hope you have a great day. Peace and very best wishes.